Hello everyone, I'm Chef Umesh from Chitkara School of Hospitality, and today we are going to learn about the basics of soups. In our previous chapters, we have learned different cuts of vegetable and their uses, meats and their uses. The objective to learn about the soup is to learn the basic classification of soups with some examples and to know the basic recipe of a thin or clear soup known as consomme with 10 garnishes. But prior to that, I would ask, what is a soup? Well, in books, it says that soup is a flavorful and nutritious liquid, savory food served at the beginning of meal, or it can be served as a light meal also. In other terms, soup is a liquid food consisting of meat, seafood, vegetables, cereals, or poultry. Traditionally in France, soupe was a slice of bread on which the contents of a cooking pot known as potage was poured. The word soup comes from the Latin suppare, which means soaking, and once described a dish of meat or vegetables that was soaked in the liquid in which it was cooked. Let's move to classification of soups. Well, soups can be broadly classified into two categories or types, that is thick soup and thin soup, which are further classified into various categories. This is done based on the texture of the soups. However, there are certain soups that are neither thin or thick, and so sometimes these soups are also classified into a different category known as international soup. So soups, thin and thick, are further classified into other categories. Under thin, we have broth and consomme. Under thick, we have puree soup, velouté, cream, bisque and chowder. The other categories of soup which do not fall under thin or thick are cold and international soups. Let's discuss clear soup or thin soup in brief. Well, these soups are unthickened, thin liquid. They never coat the back of the spoon, and they may be served plain or garnished with a variety of vegetables and meats. For example, broth and bouillon. Broth is a stock-based soup which is not thickened. It is served unpassed and garnished with chopped herbs, vegetables or meats. For example, scotch broth and minestrone. Bouillon is French term for broth. Then comes consomme, about which we are going to read further in next slides. Well, before that, let me tell you that consomme is a concentrated, rich, flavorful stock or broth that has been clarified using egg whites, or that has been strained with the help of egg whites. The word consomme has derived from French word consummate, means bring to completion or perfection. Thick soups. Well, a thick soup, unlikely thin soup, is not clear or transparent. Rather, they are opaque and they are thickened either by adding a thickening agent such as roux, which is a cooked mixture of butter and flour in equal quantities, or by puring one or more of their ingredients to provide a heavier consistency. Under thick soups, we have cream soups, which is a past thick soup. It may be vegetables based or meat based. Cream soups are soups that are thickened with roux, barmani, liaison or other added thickening agents plus milk and cream. Next, puree soup. Puree are soups that are naturally thickened by puring one or more of their ingredients. Bisque. It is a French term and it means these are the soups which are thickened and past soups made from shellfish, or the fishes having some sort of shells, for example crabs, prawns, etc. Traditionally, it is thickened with rice and finished with cream. For example, lobster bisque. A bisque is made with concentrated stock of shellfish such as shrimp, lobster, cream and roux. Even the shells are added for flavor during cooking. Chowder. Chowders are not strained and traditionally they are seafood based soups. Chowders are hearty soups made from fish, shellfish or vegetables. Valute. Valute is a thick soup which is thickened with a blonde roux, passed and finished with liaison. Then comes cold soups. Well, as the name suggests, these are served cold. A cold soup is a specialty soup that may be cooked or uncooked and then chilled. This decision depends on the ingredients. Yogurt, cream, pureed fruits are often used as a thickener for cold soups. Some cooked cold soups are vichyssoy, which is a cold version of potato and leek soup. And some uncooked cold soups are gupasho or gazpacho. International soups. As the name suggests, these are soups which are famous across the nations or cultures. These soups use ingredients that are associated with the culture's cuisine. This is a catch. All categories that include soups that don't fit well into the main categories and the soups that are native to particular countries or regions, most of the national soups are unpassed soup. For example, bouillabaisse, which is a French soup, and it is a classical French seafood based soups. Muligatwani, which originated in India, and it is a chicken vegetable soup flavored with Indian spice, pepper and water. Similarly, as we read, Scotch broth, which is from Scotland, and it is a soup of lamb stock based thin soup with vegetable and barley. Here we have a picture depicting thin soups having broth, which are stock based soups, consomme, which are concentrated, rich, flavorful and clarified stock. Thick soups, as we read, has been classified into cream, puree, bisque, chowder and valute. These soups are thickened . Now let's read something about commonly used garnishes for soups. For example, in the first picture, we can see some profiteroles rolls which are prepared from choux paste that you will learn in bakery. They are miniature cream puffs which may be filled, used plain. Then we have croutons. These are very famous garnishes created from dices or other shapes of bread, which are toasted. Then we have meat. Usually small dices or julienne of meat products are used. Cheese, balls or grated parmesan served with croutons on one side are also served. Then we have some vegetable which are cut in various sizes, shapes. For example, julienne, round slices, macedoine, etc. Cream is also used as a garnish. Most of the times, unsweetened whipped cream or sour cream is used in different types of garnishes. Let's jump to consomme and its variation. But before that, we have to discuss what consomme is. As we read that consomme is a rich, flavorful stock-based soup. It is a thin soup clarified with the help of egg whites and other mixtures. That we are going to read in the recipe of a consomme. The different consomme variations are consomme royal, consomme julienne, consomme brunoise, consomme celestine, consomme briton. So these names are considered with consomme as with the garnish, as associated with the garnish. For example, in consomme royal, dices, savory egg custard is usually used. In consomme julienne, as the name suggests, julienne vegetables are used. Consomme macédoine consists of macédoine cut vegetables. Our next slide shows us a basic recipe of consommé. Prior to that, let's discuss about standard portion sizes of soups. Well, if we are serving a soup as an appetizer portion, we have to serve almost 200 to 250 ml or milliliters of per soup per portion. In main course, it goes to 300 to 350 ml per portion. Temperature, if soups are cold soups, then we have to serve them chilled. But if they're hot, we have to take extreme care to serve them in hot cups or bowls. There are certain key points for the preparation and service of the soups. For example, soup should be strong and flavorful, and a flavorful stock should be used to create a good soup. Soup should be thin or light, but if the soup is either thin or light, it should be served before a heavy entree. Heavy soup portion should be small, and a light soup can be served in larger quantity. The soup should not contain any substance which require a lot of chewing. Consommé, it should be amber in color. Accompaniment should be crisp, for example, Melba toast, crackers, breadsticks, cheese, croutons, etc. About the portion, in appetizer, it is served around 180 to 240 milliliters, and in main course, 300 to 360 milliliters of per portion is served. Now our basic consommé's recipe includes these ingredients, which are chicken stock, chicken mince, mirepoix, which is a mix of vegetables, or you can say root vegetables, egg whites, sachet de pies, tomatoes, onion browned on a pan, and salt and pepper. This recipe can be used to create 10 number of portions of consommé. To make a consommé, we have to mix the chicken mince with mirepoix vegetables, egg whites and tomatoes. Add the mix of vegetables and everything to cold chicken stock and put into a heavy bottom pot. Put on medium heat and keep stirring the liquid until the chicken mince start to form a raft. This diagram shows a picture of raft created on top of the soup or consommé. When the raft becomes a little firm, make a cross with a knife so that you can see the liquid simmering below the raft. After 30 minutes, place the brown onions without disturbing the raft. The brown onions give the desired amber color when the raft has hardened and soup is clear. Take it off the fire and strain the liquid using muslin cloth to get a clear liquid called consommé. And with this, we would end our chapter, The Basics of Soups. For any queries, you may reach out to me at umesh.chukran@chitkara.edu.in. Thank you.